is how to fix the Zimbabwean economy. Number one, the government must, as a matter of urgency, repeal Statutory Instrument 142 of 2019. In other words, we need, as a matter of urgency, to go back to the regime of multiple currencies. Even with our own local currency, it doesn't matter. The exchange rate will find an equilibrium. But we need to restore multiple currencies, in particular the US dollar and the rand, as legitimate legal tender in this country. That's number one. Number two, we need, as a matter of urgency, amend the Reserve Bank Act of Zimbabwe to stop the Reserve Bank from printing money and from engaging in quasi-fiscal activities. So we need to protect the economy against the excesses and the rogue behavior of the central bank. Number three, we need to ban export surrender requirements. So the bank, the Reserve Bank, must stop taking people's money in the name of export surrender requirements. But as a quid pro quo, all our exporters must also bank their money in local nostro FCAs, so that the market can have easy access to foreign currents, and the rate, the exchange rate, will lower down. So export surrender requirements must go. Number four, we need to ring fence pensions. So pensions and savings must be ring fenced in US dollar terms, so that people don't lose a value. You know, that's so key. Number five, we need to liberalize the fuel market. Anyone with free funds should be able to import fuel, so that fuel is available and fuel is cheap. Number six, we need, as a matter of urgency, to allow ZESA to levy their charges in US dollars. That way they can have money to import the 400 megawatts of electricity that is required. Number seven, we need to set up, as a matter of urgency, a productivity fund that will allow struggling companies to have cheap access to money to resuscitate industry. Number eight, we need to offer trade-offs and incentives to the informal sector. The informal sector is now the economy. So, for instance, in the gold sector, we need to make sure that we have received export surrender requirements, and we make sure that there's a gold buying center in every part of Zimbabwe which will buy gold that we can sell. That's an incentives. So we need to offer trade-offs and incentives to the informal sector, so that the informal sector becomes small to middle income businesses. So that's very important. We need to revive productivity. Number 10, we need to get rid of command agriculture. We need to get rid of command agriculture as a matter of urgency. But when we get rid of command agriculture, we need to offer incentives to the farming sector, which are the following. Number one, every farmer must have a title deed. Then two, the banking sector must mobilize resources now to finance agriculture, now that security can be provided for in the form of title deeds. Number 10, it's probably number 11, there has to be a wage sector reform. The wage bill is 95% of total expenditure. There are over 400,000 ghost workers that are employed by ZANU-PF that are on the payroll right now. So ghost workers must be removed. And also, anyone who has got a farm, why should anyone who owns a farm given by the government be working? You understand? So the wage bill must be reduced to at least 30% of total expenditure, or to 7 to 8% of GDP. Next, we need to deal with state-owned enterprises. With so many parastatals that are looting and milking government, they have to be privatized, they have to be sold off, because they're just avenues of looting. Then we need to attract money in this country. That can only come through macroeconomic stability. So we have to restore fiscal consolidation. We have to go back to what I used to call we eat what we kill. So if we kill a rat, we eat a rat. The problem of this government is that it has been killing rats and very poor thin rats for the last 6 years, but eating elephants, hence the $10.6 billion theft. So we must go back to macroeconomic stability. We eat what we kill, fiscal consolidation. Next, we must cut all taxes, including and in particular, the immediate removal of the intermediated transfer tax. So the 2% tax must fall as a matter of urgency. Namhla, kathesi, the 2% tax must fall. We must reduce corporate tax and introduce a flat tax across the board of 15%, because we've restored multiple currencies. We must have wage sector reform and pay government civil servants in US dollars. Lastly, gross capital formation. Gross capital formation. We have to invest in our infrastructure, and we need about $20 billion. But to do this, we need to resolve the problem of the current sovereign debt structure. So we have to negotiate with the World Bank, with the international community, and this requires a government that is respected by the international community. ZANU is not respected. I don't think that we should waste time with SMPs and so forth. We need to grab the bull by the horns, negotiate with the United States of America, negotiate with the Paris Club of creditors, and seek debt cancellation on the quid pro quo of sound economic behavior. Zimbabwe's debt has to be cancelled, because Zimbabwe's debt is putting a premium to developing this country. We are not able to access the huge amounts of money that are at the World Bank, that are at the African Development Bank, because of our risk premium is too high. So we need to resolve the debt question in Zimbabwe, but only as a precondition to solving the challenge of gross capital formation in Zimbabwe. We need 2,000 megawatts of energy as a matter of urgency. We can get 1,000 megawatts from Batoka Gorge, but we have to share that with Zambia. That means we have to give out licenses to independent power producers in Sinamatela, Gokwe, in the 30 or so potential hydros in Manicaland. We need to go to alternative energy, bio energies, solar and so forth. Solar is plenty of supply. So let's call the dens in this country who are experts in solar energy. Let's call the Chinese who are experts in solar energy. Let's call the Dutch who are experts in wind energy. I was in Holland 2 weeks ago at the Minister of Foreign Affairs. We could get help on harvesting wind and solar energy in Zimbabwe. That's critical. So gross capital formation is critical. Lastly, of course, social services. It's a crime that doctors can go off on strike for over 75 days, and that we can have soft genocide in Zimbabwe. So as a matter of urgency, the conditions of services of doctors must be met. They must be paid in US dollars. We must buy, the government must buy drugs. The government must buy new equipment. We must import doctors from all over, including our own doctors. So the social crisis is biting. And we have to resolve that. So those are about, if you account, probably 20 issues that are essential to fix the Zimbabwean economy today.